we see that there are some of the things which can be implemented. So one example could be, you see the report is manual in nature. Okay. Probably if somebody from the IT team, or if there is somebody who is trained on creating a macro, which can take 30 minutes. Okay. The person will invest 30 minutes and the macro is being created. Now, if we are doing a project on improving the turnaround time, okay, and reporting can play a very, very important role. So that can improve the process. Okay. So any small, small opportunity, it doesn't have to be a big. Sometime it could be a big opportunity that you've identified, but you don't have a solution for it at the moment. So you can say that it's a quick win that I've identified, but we will explore this in the analyze phase. That is also you can do. But yes, in a nutshell, the quick win says that it has to be small, small opportunities, which will give a lift to my CTQ to some extent. Okay. Maybe 0.1% or maybe 0.5%, because something is better than nothing. Okay. So it's kind of confidence building to the stakeholder and saying it to the team so that they can directly link with the goal. So that is the only purpose of quick win.
Simar, Ravi here. For example, if these quick wins, okay, so will it end here only, or it will carry forward somewhere else? Because I mean, the judgmental opportunity here, then it will never travel later stage, right? It may be a big also in the situation. Why?
Ravi, very good question. So guys, what Ravi is trying to say is that whether the quick wins gets ended here in the measure phase itself, or we can carry forward. We can carry forward it also. So let's say there are different regions or different teams. Okay. So let's say there is an opportunity to implement quick win in one of the areas, which doesn't take a lot of time. But in order to implement across all the teams or across all the regions, it's going to take a lot of time, because we'll have to take a lot many approvals. We'll have to invest a lot of time. So therefore, you can mention it as implemented in one of the places, and maybe in the improve phase, you can get it implemented across all the regions or all the places. So you can take carry forward also. And that's why we have a column here, which is called easy reversible. Whether it can be implemented or reversible in other places also.
Yeah, but again, for example, the moment we say easy reversible, then again, it has to go through the complete the process, right? Problems, data, statements, and everything has to come back again.
So here, Ravi, we are implementing it as well. Like, we are giving a solution here as well. So if I identified an opportunity, let's say if I identified an opportunity that there is a lot of manual work, okay, wherein if any kind of macro can be created, I can probably do it for one particular area and get it implemented. So the solution has been implemented, a very small solution has been implemented, and still if it cannot be implemented for the entire process, I can implement it for one place, and then I can say that for implementing it for all the regions, it will take a lot of time, because the definition of quick win is that it has to be implemented right away. But yes, I can implement it right away at one place, and for implementing it across the board, I will have to go and get it implemented in the improve phase. So that's how we will do it. So we don't have to come up with a different problem statement. It is already being identified here. We will just go ahead and replicate the same way where we have done it here.
Okay.
So this is quick wins. Please request everybody, whenever you are doing projects, before even getting into the analyze phase, come up with some quick wins opportunities. Make sure this quick win has to be implemented in maximum 15 days. Okay. It should not take more than that time. If it is taking more than 15 days, it will not be a quick win. Okay. So guys, with the help of that, we have completed the measure phase as well. We are on time. We have completed the measure phase as well. Now we will get into the analyze phase. Okay. So guys, in the analyze phase, as the name suggests, we are going to do a lot many analysis. Okay. So from define and measure, guys, does anybody remember the equation? Y is equal to fx?
Yeah.
Okay. So what is y and what is x? Can someone tell me?
Output and input.
X are the causes.
Okay. And Y is the?
CTQ.
Absolutely. Y is my CTQ. X is my causes. So define and measure, I was only focusing on Y. I was only focusing on why, because I didn't know what my causes are. The sole purpose of the analyze phase is to identify those excess using different tools, techniques. Okay. So now in the analyze phase, our focus would be on excess, of course, on why as well. But yes, on excess also, because excess are more important here, because without knowing the excess, I will not be able to solve it. So we have an agenda for the analyze phase. There are a lot many things that we're going to do. Okay. So first of all, in the analyze phase, we will understand broadly that how do we identify the excess? Before clicking on the next, what do you think? How do you identify the excess? Normally outside Six Sigma, how do you identify the excess?
Doing a root cause analysis.
Do we get to the root cause right away, or there are certain techniques which help us to get to the root cause?
Certain techniques we will use to identify the root cause.
Okay. So guys, let's first understand the difference between cause and root cause. What is cause and what is root cause? So cause could be a potential cause. Okay. So if I see one of the cause, so let's take a problem as attrition. Attrition is the percentage of people leaving the organization. Okay. That's a common metric used in any organization. Let's say my Y is attrition and my X is transportation, which means that people are not happy with the transportation and that's why they're leaving. So transportation is a cause. Do you think transportation is also a root cause? If I just know that transportation is a problem, is one of the cause, can I straight away go to the solution? Or I need to get into more detail that what is the problem that they're facing in transport, whether they are facing problem with transport is pathetic, whether I have a problem in transport taking lot much time to reach office, whether the transport service is not good, whether the behavior is not good. Getting into the root cause, getting into the detail, that is a root cause. Getting onto the first level by identifying the levers. Okay. So levers are the causes. Okay. And getting into the exact reason by doing why is a root cause. So that's what we need to do in the analyze phase. We are not only trying to identify the excess. So excess are not root causes, guys. Excess are the potential excess. And when we complete the root cause, then we get the confirmed excess. Okay. So that's what we are going to understand in the analyze phase. First of all, we identify the potential excess and then we do some kind of testing and then we get into the root cause analysis. So let's understand step by step on how to identify the excess. So guys, there are two major broadly categories of identification of excess. One is through brainstorming and another is through data stratification. So brainstorming, let's understand brainstorming first and then we'll get into data stratification. So brainstorming is method of gathering a lot of ideas within a small amount of time. So brainstorming is a perfect technique. I'm sure you all must have been using it. So for solving any sort of problem, so there is a team which is being aligned. There is a team which is being grouped together and the purpose is to identify the causes. Okay. So brainstorming can be done for various purposes. We could be doing it in our organization. Okay. There could be various purposes. One purpose could be to identify the causes. Another purpose is to be identify the solutions. Another purpose could be to identify what all projects that we should do. Another brainstorming technique could be to identify the low hanging fruit also. So brainstorming is one particular technique which help us to identify a lot many ideas within a small amount of time. So in the analyze phase, guys, what do you think we should do the brainstorming for? To identify the causes or identify the solutions?
Causes.
Identify the causes.
Identify the causes. So always remember, in the analyze phase, the first thing we are going to do is to identify the causes. For that, there is a brainstorming activity which is supposed to be done, wherein the project team leader, along with the project team members will get into a room and start conducting the brainstorming. The purpose is to identify the causes. Now, someone tell me, what is the most important thing that we should keep in mind before even doing the brainstorming? What is that most important thing?
The actual issue.
The actual issue is already aware. That's why you have set up a meeting to do the brainstorming. An actual issue is your CTQ, which we have already identified in the defined phase. We already did the MSA of the CTQ in the measure phase. Okay.
Right set of resources.
Yeah.
Sorry, Kiran.
Right set of resources.
Somebody was saying the same. Yeah. Resources, the identifying the resources first, which are...
Identifying the resources. Identify what kind of resources?
Like the right set of people and right set of material we have to brainstorm the problem.
Absolutely. We need to have the right amount of things, guys. That is the prime important thing for doing brainstorming, before even doing the brainstorming. If I don't have the right set of audience for the brainstorming, I will not be able to continue. Now, what is the right set of audience? Can someone tell me? How do you define whether it's a right or wrong? So this is something which you need to understand while doing the brainstorming. But what do you think, according to you, is a right set of audience?
The people who are actually who is working on those processes on which we are
working. The value add.
People who are working on that particular issue. What else?
Our value orders.
Can you give an example, Bhardwaj?
For example, we have seen the issue call dropping. So in the previous sessions, we have used the example. So mm-hmm. Who are the right set of people? Who is the people who are getting impacted? And what kind of issues? And what is the value add we can do from this session?
Absolutely. Very good point. The impacted people can be part of the brainstorming. So along with the project team we have, which we have identified from SIPOC, we will also call out some of the people who are impacted, some of the best performers, some of the SMEs, and some of the bottom performers as well, because these people might have some issues to be part of the brainstorming session. Okay. So that's why the brainstorming is to be done, to identify the causes which is pertaining to the problem that we have. Now, brainstorming, there are some do's and don'ts which we just talk about. Select your audience very carefully. Never allow one to dominate the session. This is basic meeting etiquettes. Always encourage out-of-box ideas and give chance everyone to speak. I'm sure you all are aware of this, so I don't have to talk about it also. The only important thing is to capture each and every idea. So no idea is a bad or a wrong or a right idea. So even though if it's being duplicated, we can take it later. But yes, we'll have to capture each and everything. Just remember, here we are not trying to identify the solution. So if anybody is giving any solution, it is our responsibility to tell the person, guys, we will take the solutions later when we do the brainstorming in the improve phase for identifying solution. But right now we are looking for the causes. What are the reasons we are getting this? Okay. And we should not criticize anybody. Now, there are some methods of brainstorming. Okay. Depending upon the audience, the nature of the audience. Okay. We should do these methods. First is a freewheel method, wherein there is a spontaneous flow of ideas by all team members, wherein you will not pick anybody and say anybody who wants to give ideas, he or she can come up with ideas. Okay. And when you see that there are some people who are not speaking at all, they are very silent, then you can use a round robin method, wherein you can ask, okay, let's say now Manish, you can speak, Mohit, you can speak, Paras, you can speak, so Kiran, you can speak. So you can take names, okay, wherein I'm just taking names here because I can see on Zoom, but you can ask people to speak, wherein you are ensuring that there are few people who are not speaking, but yes, they can also with some contributing ideas so that they can speak. That's a round robin. Then the third method is the chit and card method. So this method is also known as brain writing. Okay, wherein some people are not very confident in speaking in front of everybody, wherein they feel that some of the issues are very, very confident. They want to be kept confidential. So that's why they use the chit and card method without mentioning their names. That's how we can also do this brainstorming. So you can start with a freewheel method, move to round robin, and see if anybody wants to go for a brain writing as well. So these are the methods of doing the brainstorming. So guys, now let's do some exercise. Guys, can you see my Excel sheet?
Yes.
Okay, let's take one CTQ. So let's take one CTQ of your choice. Okay. CTQ of your choice and then do the brainstorming on it. So guys, can anybody suggest me any CTQ? Guys, you can give CTQ from your respective organization, and this is a good opportunity for you to come up with causes here, because we all are professionals, like-minded people. So it would be a great help to anybody. So this is for your benefit. I'm asking anybody to come up with any CTQ. You will be able to identify some of the potential causes.
Average handling time of processing a case.
Okay, so one CTQ is average handling time of processing the case. Okay, so guys, which means that the operational definition of HT is that the handling time, so it is the lesser the better, because the impact is that the sooner we are able to complete a transaction, the better we are able to attend the customers, and the wait time also gets reduced and the customer becomes happy. So now what do you think could be the causes? Let's do a brainstorming and let's do at least 10 causes. Okay, and I want inputs from everybody because no idea is bad idea. So we'll start with freewheel, and then I will get into rounds robin also, because I want each and every person to at least say something. And this is how you can learn on how to do a brainstorming. So guys, start. What could be the cause of an high HT?
Maybe it was not captured properly at the first instance.
Okay, so you're saying a measurement error?
Yeah, measurement error. Sorry. Okay.
Good, very good. What else?
Maybe the handler don't know the full issue with the full facts of the issue.
So process knowledge is something which you are saying is one of the reason. Okay, good.
Customer expectation.
Customer expectation. Can you be specified so that we can understand the cause?
Basically, SLA. For example, there are a couple of minutes or hour or something like which is there. But if the operating people are not very clear about it, so the expectation of what SLA has to be met, so may not be aware of it.
So SLA is already mentioned here, Ravi, which is the high HT. Okay, let's say which has to be 200 seconds. So now this is very high. Now, what do you think can be the cause?
We have unavailability of the resources.
Very good. So unavailability of resources, which means I have less people. That's the reason I'm not able to meet it.
Or we can say new associates in the team because very of good. Them. The yeah.
So new joiners. So some of the analysis being done and identified that it is new joiners who are much time due to that.
Hardware issue.
Hardware issue. You can say a technical issue or maybe a system issue. So that when they are working on the system, sometimes it gets late. Sometimes it is giving us errors. Due to that, he is not able to complete each and every transaction 200 seconds. So good. So system issue. What else?
Attendance or availability.
Sorry, Ashok. Can you please repeat?
A comprehensive list of known issues.
Comprehensive list of known issues.
Like if I'm calling for a specific issue and that issue is not identified earlier by someone, then the agent will take some time to get into it and get back on solution.
So you say there is not a list of known issues or kind of ready reckoner.
Right.
Also
not available. Okay, good. So which means there's no kind of knowledge bank available. Due to that, the person can see how to solve it. So there is no kind of repository, or I can say there is no standard operating procedure available.
I mean the training competency.
Very good. Training.
High attrition.
So training issue. Okay. So training of training activity. attrition, good point. We have high attrition and therefore we have to hire more people. So high attrition.
Distractions during the
process. Distraction.
Yeah, if the people working, they are working on some other work as well, like taking calls while they're processing.
Can you be, please be a bit specific. The more specific you are, guys, while doing brainstorming, you will get to the root cause. These are just potential causes. So let's be a little bit specific.
Okay. So
distraction, what sense? Multitasking, right. You're saying?
Yeah, maybe multitasking. We can put
it. Multitasking, where it could be that the person has to take calls and maybe work on
complexity of cases.
Different applications. Complexity, yes, good, good point. So there are some complexity, high, medium, sorry, and low. So we found that complexity could be one of the cause which is impacting high CT, high HT. So we have done kind of 11. So anybody was not spoken, I was not keeping a note of it. So has anybody was not spoken?
Hello, you were Simran, what I was saying, that if the handler does not have knowledge of all the issues at hand, but you have listed it as process knowledge. I think it should not go into process knowledge. But I'm saying that if the handler does not know the full issues at hand.
Okay, so which means that he's not understood the issue in detail. Okay.
Oh, you can list. Not about process knowledge.
Okay, so there could be a process knowledge as well, and there could be an understanding the issue as well. Okay.
Checklist.
Sorry.
Checklist kind of stuff issues. These are the items need to be checked.
Don't get into the solution right now. Don't get into the solution. Just talk about the cause.
Lack of accountability, can we say?
How would you measure lack of accountability?
Again, it is a job description of the role.
Okay, good. Very nice. So lack of accountability of users, agents, while performing the task. Very good.
Or maybe fear of getting the quality impacted. Maybe they're taking more time.
Okay, very good. So quality scores or quality percentage.
So previous data, can we say the past data?
Previous.
The previous data or something like, for example, for analysis purpose or something like.
Which data? How? What calls are we talking?
How many calls? Yeah. How many calls have been? Is coming in a daily or hourly basis. How are taking more time? How are, what kind of, complexity? Some kind of analysis, data analysis.
That data analysis would come later. We are just kind of looking at the gut feeling at the moment, what people think. We will categorize in these as data and process later. I will tell you the technique. But right now, let's focus on these causes, okay? So guys, let's say we have done the brainstorming and identified 14 potential causes, okay? So these 14 causes are the ones which is impacting to your problem, and we need to now work on this. So we have kind of prepared a material to work on it. So this is a basic thing, guys, which we need to do, an exercise which is called a brainstorming technique to identify the potential causes. And with the help of these causes, we probably will collect the data, we will get into the root cause and then do all these stuff. So but this is a basic activity. Usually, for any black belt sort of a project, you can get up to 30 to 40 kind of causes. So we're just doing an exercise here, okay? But you should drill more. This exercise should take at least an hour's time to complete, but I'm just showing you the technique. So that's why we would limit it to this only, but it doesn't mean that you have to go for only these. So you all are professional, you know the complexity of it. So let's assume that these are the only one we have identified. So after doing the brainstorming, now, after doing the brainstorming, we'll have to use a tool which is called fishbone analysis. Okay, so guys, this is one of the wonderful tool which is being used, which is called fishbone analysis. Fishbone analysis is a tool which is also called as cause and effect diagram, wherein we already got the effects, and now we are trying to categorize the causes. And there is another name which is called the Ishikawa diagram. So one tool has three names: fishbone diagram, because the shape of this tool is like a fish. Okay. Second is the Ishikawa diagram, because the name of the person who invented this tool is called Mr. Ishikawa. And third is the cause and effect diagram, okay, or cause and effect analysis. What is the purpose? Let's see. Cause and effect diagram is an analysis tool that provides a systematic way of looking at effect and cause that contributing to those effects. It is a pictorial representation of the potential axis. The design of the diagram looks like a skeleton or a fish, is often referred as fishbone diagram. So fishbone diagram or cause and effect diagram or Ishikawa diagram is a tool which is helped to categorize, pictorially categorize the causes identified from brainstorming. So sometimes people make mistakes, and just pay attention to what I'm saying right now. It's very, very important. People make mistake by saying that fishbone is a tool which is used to identify the causes. Guys, no. Identification of causes was already done using brainstorming, which we just did. Fishbone or cause and effect tool is a tool which is identified to categorize or affinitize the causes that we've identified. Okay, we will talk about why are we affinitizing it later. But yes, there is a second step which is called categorizing these causes under different headers or different categories. That particular technique is called the fishbone analysis, fishbone technique. So these categories, the standard categories, could be cause due to the manpower issue, could be due to the machine, which is kind of a system, mother nature, which is kind of an environmental reason, measurement, it's because of the measurement error, method, because of a process gap, and material, because of any kind of a raw material. Okay. So this is how the fishbone diagram looks like. Here it comes the Y, which is the effect, the CTQ, and here we identify the causes. And you see these are different categories under which we have categorized these causes as. Okay. So now let's understand these categories into detail. First category which you can categorize is could be personal or man. Any cause which is related to the people issues, like the way in people working, could be the personal issues. Example could be lack of training, lack of experience, people kind of issues, skill issues. Second is a method or process. Any potential gaps in the process, like lack of standardized work, some extra steps, process not defined clearly, that you categorize under process or method. Equipment or any technical sort of any hardware sort of issue would come under machines or equipment. Any material related input like late delivery, different order types would come into material. Any cause which is related to the measurement system will come into a measurement system. And any potential cause which is uncontrollable or due to environmental condition because of severe weather, COVID-19, change in market, anything would come under mother nature. Okay, so these are the six major M's, okay, which are used: man, method, machine, material, measurement, mother nature. This is not compulsory. You can use your own categories also to categorize, okay, depending upon the causes that you've identified. It is not compulsory to ensure we have all the six M's. Could be a possibility that while doing exercise, you only found four types of categories, okay, wherein you are able to categorize all the causes under four. You can use more than that also, but these are the standard categories which are used to categorize the causes under different headers. Okay, so let's go back and see. So guys, let's categorize these causes under different headers. So measurement error, what do you think, which category should it go under?
Man.
Measurement error. So measurement error, if it is
system.
Measurement system, very good. Measurement. Process knowledge, what do you think it should go under?
People.
Men.
Okay. Man. It would go under men or people. You can give any name as per your convenience. Unavailability of resources.
Method.
Very good. So it's a process kind of a gap. It is not mother nature. It is not uncontrollable. If there is unavailability of resources, you can have the people onboarded. It is not environmental. It is not possible. It is possible. New joiners.
Unavailable resources, doesn't that come in the men or people?
This is a kind of a process gap. It is not pertaining to a particular person or a people. it is a process gap that I don't have enough resources in the team. Okay. It is a process which needs to be streamlined to ensure that we have a right amount of bandwidth, right amount of availability of people in the team. If I don't have the, so let's say I should be able to meet the demand versus the volume. So which I have not done the forecasting. That's why I was not able to get the resources onboarded. Okay. So it's a process gap. New joiners. So which means new joiners are not new joiner. Men. HT is high. Okay. Men, yes, absolutely right.
Manpower.
System issue.
Machine
or system, you can give technology, any name you can give. Okay. List of known issue, ready reckoner not available.
Men.
Not men, guys. This is not particular
method.
Person.
Method
this does not exist. So method or process. This is a process gap. Standard operating procedure not available. This is also method a process gap. Training effectiveness.
Again, process.
You can give any other name also. You can give training as well. Okay, one of the calls, one of the categories. Or you can give method and process also. If you want to be more specific, you can give training also. Your wish. High attrition.
Men.
This is management.
Right, okay.
Okay. Multitasking, take calls and work on different applications.
Again, method or process.
Okay. Method and process. Complexity high, medium, and low.
Measurement.
Material.
This will come under material, absolutely. Material. Understood the issue in detail or not understood the issue in detail. That should be the cause. What is this?
Lack of process knowledge or method or process.
Category.
Method or process.
People.
Manual people.
People.
Lack of accountability of users, agents while performing the task.
Method, process.
Process. Again, process.
This is process. Method. Okay, method. Very good. Quality scores or quality percentage.
Better measurement.
This will again get into material. So guys, now you see we have categorized these, 14 causes into somewhat 3 or 4 categories. Okay. Now, what do you think is the benefit of doing this? What have I achieved after this?
We have grouped under. We have grouped the issues into classified objects.
But why have we done it? What is the benefit that I'll be getting after doing this?
So we are able to break down the problem into more relevant steps.
More relevant steps or like more relevant categories?
Categories.
Or themes. That is something which we have done. We can clearly see that. But what is the benefit?
Same, Sima, are you telling me that 4 and more distinct categories? So we are getting 4 and more.
No, this
we
is not
are the building same. Solution, so we'll consider this category.
Sorry, Bhadwaj, what are you saying?
When we are building the solution, so we'll tag the issues in the particular category. From there on, we'll find out the solution.
You're very, very close, but I want you to be more clear in clarity. What is the purpose of doing it?
Root cause.
Root cause is an outcome, but how would I get into the root cause? What is that one thing we have to do?
We need to find out cause.
Sorry, Shailesh, can you please speak a bit louder?
It is to find out the cause.
Yes, so, but how do we do that?
Analysis.
Analysis by doing what?
Segmenting.
Attributed analysis.
Effect. Understand the effect of this one.
How would I do that?
Categorizing the problem.
Categorizing, we already done it. But after categorizing, what benefit I will get? step by
step. I can break the more into the detail in that particular category.
I can understand where should I work.
Yeah, which category is more contributing?
Which categories is more contributing? That I can see, that is not difficult. But what will I do with that category? Is that more important? Let me give you a hint. What will you do with
data
these
categories? Data separation.
Data is already generated. It is not difficult. What will you do with this data? That is important.
Yeah, we have to separate.
Analyzing.
Basically, it will help you to identify the quickens among the causes which we can hit first, and then we can prioritize the causes solutions.
Ashok, I can see the causes here also.
Mm-hmm.
I can start these causes like here, but what is the purpose of doing it, of categorization?
Better analyze
for assigning the work.
Absolutely. So this particular activity is helping me to assign the work. Okay, whom should I get in touch with? So for example, if I have unavailability of resources, let me just select all the method and process. Okay. So unavailability of resources, list of known issue, SOP not available. For all these, I identified it as a process gap. Now I have to get in touch with the process head for resolving it. Okay. For any sort of management issues, I will get in touch with the management. Maybe the head of the department or maybe the director. Anything which is related to technology, I will get in touch with the IT team. So guys, the purpose of doing the fishbone analysis or categorizing is to know whom do I need to get in touch with to solve this problem.
Who is the person?
Accountability, absolutely. Who is the person or team or group responsible to work on this particular cause? How do I know that? How should I attack this? Let's forget, if you don't have done this, okay? Do you have any sort of idea? How would you be solving it? Do you think categorizing makes more simple, more clear, and getting closer to the problem? Or without categorizing, it is more closer to the problem? What do you think?
Categorizing is more simple.
Categorizing is more simple, and it is giving you a layer that whom should you get in touch with to solve it, to get to the next level. So that is why we do the categorization, which is done with the help of fishbone analysis, or it is known as Ishikawa, or known as cause and effect diagram. So what we have learned right now is, I think we should take a break in 5 minutes, 5-10 minutes. What we have understood is, first of all, the first step is to identify the causes using brainstorming, the way we have done it. Second step, which is called fishbone, to pictorically identify and categorize those causes under different headers. Okay, so that is which is called the fishbone. Right. Anybody has any question on the brainstorming, the difference between brainstorming and the fishbone? Are we clear?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Wonderful. Now, guys, identifying, let's say, 14 causes, how would you start working on it? Which of these causes do you think we should attack first, and which of these causes should I attack later? How do you know that?
Prioritization.
Do you all agree? Some kind of prioritization?
Yes.
Prioritization is very, very important. So in the brainstorming exercise itself, we'll have
ranking.
We'll have to do the ranking, wherein we have to categorize these causes under impact, which could
high, medium, low.
High, medium, and low. Absolutely. Okay. So there is a technique of doing it. Okay. We have to do a kind of a multi-voting, wherein we ask the team and ask them, what do you think? If more than 70% of the people agrees to one particular cause, okay, then only we consider that as a high, medium, or low. So let's do that also in 10 minutes. Okay, let's categorize this as high, medium, and low impact. High impact means working on this cause will have a high impact on my CTQ, which is HT. Okay, so let's do this as well and categorize this as high, medium, and low. So let's go one by one. So guys, measurement error. If you see that measurement error is one of the problem, do you think it will have high, medium, or low impact?
I feel high.
Simar, one question. This high, medium, low categorization means like the how it impacts the CTQ, right? That's the base of. So when you do the brainstorming, will you have the enough data in doing the brainstorming to categorize that?
Sorry, can you please repeat it? I didn't get the question.
Yeah, so when you along with the team, we do the brainstorming. So will we have enough data to substantiate what is high, medium, low? I mean, to see whether that impacts the CTQ most.
Right. Yeah, so that technique, Manish, we'll be doing it next, okay, wherein we will do the data door and process door. But let's take the team voting. Okay, since I've told you that we have taken people from the team who are there in the process for some amount of time, there are some experienced people, there are some top performers. So that's why we consider 70% as a threshold. Data analysis would come at later stage. We will do the data part as well. But right now, this high, medium, and low is basis your vintage, basis your experience, basis the kind of knowledge that you have in the process, and your basis that only we are considering high, medium. Okay. So measurement system is definitely a high, because if the measurement error is there, there is going to a huge impact. So there should not be any measurement error. So I agree that the impact should be high. Process knowledge. What do you think? If there is a process knowledge gap, people are not knowledgeable, do you think it will have a high impact?
Medium.
It could be a medium or high. Okay, so let's see how many people are saying high or medium. So depending upon that, because that's why this comes into picture, because that's why there's a brainstorming. If you see how many people are saying high, which means that there is a gap. But if you see only few people say high, then you will see whether it's medium or low. So guys, one voice, what do you feel?
High.
Okay, so I will go as high. Unavailability of resources. I have less people in the team. That's why my HT is high. Team HT is high.
Medium.
High.
It's pretty high.
High.
Okay, so this is also high. New joiners HT is high.
Low. Medium.
Low.
So this is kind of medium, because there is only certain category of people who's impacting. But if we do the data analysis and found this is contributing high, probably then we can change it as well. But as of now, we feel, because we are part of the process and we feel the new joiner volume is very, very low, so there we say it's a medium category, and we believe that slowly and gradually they will improve. System issue.
Hi.
The thing I found that due to system issue, people are not able to do it on time. They take a lot of time. So do you think it's a very high impact?
Medium. I feel it's a medium.
Okay, depending upon what you guys say. So I'm mentioning it as medium. I don't have any known issue, ready reckoner available. So I get confused whether. So do you think it's a high impact? Yes, please contribute. We have to do this activity in the next 4 minutes. So whatever you think, it's a purpose of.
Low.
It can be low.
Yes, low.
Yes, low. Medium. Low. There is no standard operating procedure. There is no standardization of how I'm doing.
Medium.
Training effectiveness.
Medium.
Trainer was
medium.
Attrition is very high.
High.
This is important.
High.
Yeah.
Low.
Multitasking.
Low.
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 Okay. Complexity. High, medium, and low.
Medium.
Okay. I have not understood the issue in detail.
Medium.
Medium.
Okay. Medium. Lack of accountability of users, which means a skill issue, which means hiring issue.
High. Medium.
High.
I feel it's a high, because this is high. The first high. Step Yeah, because if I don't hire right amount of people, let's say I need people who with good typing speed and with probably with good bent of mind, analytical mind, and I don't have those people on board, then it will definitely impact my HT, right? Quality score. So I have a pressure in mind ki I have to maintain the quality, and I that's why I'm rushing. So what do you think?
It's a high
only. Yeah. Okay.
So now out of these 14, I have categorized and identified 6 of them as high. So I'll have to prioritize it. I'll have to work on the first high impact ones. Okay. So for that, there is a tool called cause and effect matrix. Okay. Earlier we learned cause and effect diagram. So don't get confused, guys. The name remains the same. Only the last alphabet changes. Fishbone is cause and effect diagram or cause and effect analysis. This is cause and effect matrix. This is used for prioritizing the causes. It's a judgment based tool. It captures the knowledge and experience of team members. Likewise, we did. And it makes the process somewhat objective. Earlier it was very subjective. Now we are making it very objective. So guys, this is how the cause and effect matrix template looks like. So we'll give a rating here. For all the high impact, we gave a rating of 9. For all the medium impact, we gave a rating of 3. And for all the low, the rating is 1. Okay. And then there is a common multiplier, which is 10. We multiply it with and we get a score. So all the high would get a 90 score, all the medium will get a 30 score, and all the low ones will get a 10 score. Okay. So this is a third technique after brainstorming that we get into the high ones. So, and then we categorize into process door and data door. So after process door and data door, we'll take a break. So process door and data door. Let's understand this, guys, process door and data door. This is very, very important. And this is where the actual data analysis starts. Now, for any cause, if you have a data available for doing the analysis, you will classify this as a data door. For any cause which you don't have data available, like say if people say motivation is one of the cause, can you measure motivation? Yes or no?
No.
So for process door and data door, we categorize it into process door and data door. So for getting into the root cause, we use different tools for data door and we use different tools for process door. Okay. For getting into the root cause. So let's do this here as well. So measurement error. Do you think you can have data for measurement error?
Yes.
Okay, so it's a data door.
Data door, yeah.
Process knowledge.
Process door it is.
Process door.
Process door.
It can be a data door also, guys. If there is a kind of a mechanism wherein there is a test which is happening probably every month or twice a month, wherein you have scores, wherein you can compare whether people who has high, people who have less scores, and also have high HT, probably you can do a correlation. But if most of the time we don't have the process knowledge scores, so you can get into process. Unavailability of resources. Can you quantify that?
Yeah, it can be. I think
absolutely. It can
be. Yeah, we can.
You can do it. That how many resources that I have and what is my HT? You can get the data out of it. Okay. New joiner HT is high. This is also a data door.
Data door.
System issue.
It can be data door. How many times systems can be?
It can be data door that you can see a report. If you are maintaining a report, guys, it is up to you. If there is a person in the team who's maintaining a data, so data door, list of known ready reckoner issue not available. I think this is a process because this is common.
Process.
So the one which is common for all, it's a process door. SOP not available, process. Again, it's a process door.
Process.
Training effectiveness. So if you have a training scores
data
available.
Door. Data.
Process door. Okay, data door.
Depending upon. Okay, high duration, data door.
Data. Yeah.
Multitasking, data. Taking calls, you can't measure it. Okay?
Yeah.
It's a process door.
Process
complexity, door. Yes, it's a data door. I can categorize how many high, medium, and low. I have not understood the issue in detail. It's a process door. lack of accountability of user while performing the task.
Process door.
Data door.
Oh, data door.
Can, if I can, while doing some kind of interview, then it could be a data. And I think quality score is data. Guys, you see here, the third category is the process door and the data door. Now, what I've done is I've categorized these into process door and data door. So I only have to look for high impact ones here. I have identified six causes as high in impact, wherein I found out of high, there are four data door and two of them are process door. So for doing the analysis for data door, there is a different technique. For doing the analysis for process door, there's a different, which we will talk about after the break. But yes, these are the four different ways wherein we will categorize the causes. So before going into the break, 2 minutes, what are the four different steps of identification of causes? Let's do one by one. What is the first step?
Brainstorming.
Very good. Brainstorming. Okay, so I'm just mentioning the tool here and the purpose. What is the purpose of brainstorming?
Identify
the causes. Very good. Second step. What is that?
Fishbone.
Very good. Here we do.
Categorize
the causes. Very good. Third step. What is the tool? Cause and effect matrix.
Cause and effect.
Purpose is to
understand the impact.
Prioritize the causes. That's yes. Right. Understand the impact. Yeah. You're correct. Fourth step. Classify the data. Purpose is process door, data door. Get the root cause. Guys, these are the four basic rules of doing any sort of analysis. Okay. First, we do a brainstorming. Second, we categorize fishbone. Third, we prioritize. And fourth, we classify. Anybody has any question? Guys, are we good?
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Wonderful.